Hello YouTube and welcome to my channel. Today I'll be doing a tutorial video on exporting images and animations from DragonBones Pro. Now first of all, before I start here, just noting on the what's new on 5.5, you've got the option here that is Canvas, or was it 5.3? I'm not sure, one of those two. But this was added on request by DragonBones. Now if I switch the option on, noting that it's going to display a borderline on my actual drawing area or modeling area, DragonBones Pro, which will actually limit the exporting extent when I'm actually on the export phase. What we've got here is obviously sliders. We can change the X location, the Y location, the width and the height, but the minimum image area is going to encapsulate everything in animation and keep that in the border. It's almost like the option for fit minimum area. Additionally, you can add a color to your border here and also show that in stage of the background color displays. Now switching that off because I need to have a clear transparent background. Now if I look at the thumb there, we've got the export project command there, which is Control E. If you guys would like to use the shortcut command, once I launch that, it's going to obviously open up the export dialog box where I can choose between animation data and texture, images and HTML format. Now on the first one, animation data texture, we've got a target set to armature, and I think that you can change it to any of the other symbols available. Additionally, you can change the data config options from DragonBones JSON, DragonBones binary, EGRT fast, EGRT MC, and also the spine versions. Now I think that the DragonBones JSON and the spine then does have a versioning available. The DragonBones binary option is apparently a lot faster than the JSON and EGRT and all of those file types, and actually might actually replace JSON file for DragonBones Pro, but I can't say that. That's just what I may be guessing since it's a better performance. Additionally, on the EGRT fast, you cannot export meshes. So if I select that, it's going to give me a warning there that's saying that this product contains mesh or bounding box attachments which cannot export EGRT fast. So if I have my option selected for the DragonBones JSON file, noting we've got a texture config which can either be an image type with a texture atlas or images. Images is individual options, and texture atlas is basically a single image with all of your individual images on that. It's going to be saved as one item. There are some additional options on here that you can actually can choose from, like for instance removing strip white space, will remove blank space on this export. Also auto sizing, which you can switch off and change the own size parameters, and additionally some heuristics options for the output. Now I'm going to leave it as the base fit area as a default option. Additionally, you can change the scale for your export, noting that if your actual armature images are quite big or larger than a certain property, it will scale it down automatically. Like for instance, the tree that I have, the winter tree or the dead tree, and automatically scales down by 50%. Just still on. Okay, I thought I had a call there. Nope, it's a missed call. It's okay. So I can move on. We've got a background color option there, which is set to transparent. We can actually add onto a custom if you really need to, but I'm going to leave that off for transparent. Now the output path is by default. You can obviously go change it to the browse option. You can change the project name, and you can change these video options and choose if you want to use a zip file. Now that's the option that I usually use when I export the images or the animations for you guys to import. Switching over to the image area, noting that again we can change the target. We can also change the format from PNG, JPEG and GIF. Additionally, we can change the sequence or the time to sequence or single frame. So if I export a single frame, notice that I'll be able to choose the frames that I want to export from the walking animation or which frame. And as soon as I do that, I can go preview that option. It'll preview me what that actual image is. But I don't want that. I want the sequence, and it's going to export all of these 24 frames as per specified here to the folder location in the output path. Something to note there, in that this is why I mentioned the canvas area. Your image contains usually set to minimum area, which is on default, and you can now limit it to the canvas area, which makes it a lot better, especially when you've got to export these frames and collate it in a video export. You can also obviously change it to custom and change it on the go, like for instance with the canvas tool. This setting applies for JPEG as well. The only difference is you'll have a background color assigned, And noting that on PNG and JPEG, you have the option to package all your textures, and once you export that, it will be on one single PNG or JPEG image. GIFs, same options, just I think the only difference is you can't package the texture and also have the same format. What I've got here though, on the HTML export, obviously again a target, but you have the option to change between preview and publish. The difference between that, once I export its preview on with the output scale, a background color, and a grid, I'm going to say finish that, write it out for me, and I'll open it on the screen here for you guys. So you can see it actually exports with a... Here we go. It exports with... let me just zoom in my web browser and scroll out from the viewer. We'll have additional... We are able to change some of the armatures or animations if there's any additional, and we can change the speed and so forth. So it allows for additional controls within it. It's just a preview. You can obviously switch off the grid, but this was discussed previously. The one I want to get to, which might yield some exciting updates in the near future, is the publish part, which allows you to change the frames per second, allows you to embed the frames per second into the animation, and also change some additional options. Not much more, just some screen rotation options. But once that exports, it will export a HTML document, which is just animation. Now, if you want to go a little bit more in detail, you can actually press Control. I think it's Control U. No, not Control U. Control Shift U, is it? Let me just Google this quickly. HTML coding in Chrome. No, that's not Chrome, that's Internet Explorer. Why am I opening Internet Explorer? Sorry about this. But I can actually press Control U and F12. Well, I guess that's it. I don't like Internet Explorer that much, but it allows you to actually view how this HTML document has been coded. So if you think about it, you can actually use that to build a website. But obviously maybe some good news coming soon, and I'll definitely cover that once that has been revealed from DragonBones Pro. So if you guys like this video, please like it. If you'd like to see more, please subscribe, and enjoy the rest of your evening.